Lay that pistol down, boy. Lay that pistol down. Pistol packing. Okay, maybe that's not really the best intro for the movie Winchester. G'day Darkrealmers, it's horror author and illustrator Michael J. Elliott here with you again today. And today we're going to be looking at the movie Winchester. If this is your first trip to the Diaries, welcome. Thanks so much for joining us. And if you want to keep up with the best in horror from books and movies, then hit that subscribe button and the bell notification and you'll always be on top. Okay, Darkrealmers. Now, I was very interested in this movie when I first saw the trailer as a movie that was about to be released. And when I saw it on Netflix, of course it went onto my must-watch list. And what surprised me at the very start, which I didn't know, was that this movie is an Australian and USA co-production, because the first credits that come up show you that it's by Eclipse Films, but it's also partly made with the assistance of the Queensland Film Board, New South Wales Film Board, and the Victorian Film Board. And so that was really nice to know that this movie was a co-production, and that as a co-production it did really well. Now, this movie stars, it's based on facts, okay, but just the bare bones, if you understand. Now, Helen Mirren, wonderful actress, plays Sarah Winchester, who is the daughter of the founder of the Winchester Repeating Arms or Firearms Company, and she still owns 51% of the company. And she lives in this sprawling mansion, and the strange thing about Sarah Winchester is that she is constantly adding rooms to this mansion. And it's all based on her belief that anyone who has been killed through an accident or through murder or whatever circumstances, by a Winchester rifle, can't find any rest. They're there, you know, to haunt her and make her feel guilty and so forth. Now, into this comes Dr. Eric Price, who is played by Jason Clarke, and he is a character who is battling his own demons, the loss of his wife, he's struggling through that, and he sort of compensates with the attentions of ladies of the night, shall we say, which is when we first encounter him. And he also, we find out, is addicted to, well, I assumed he was addicted to laudanum. And during the first few scenes of the movie, one of the board members from the Winchester Company comes to Dr. Price and says, we need you to give Miss Winchester a medical examination to see if she's still medically fit to, you know, sit on the board and have 51% control of the company. So in other words, it was just a nice way of saying, look, is she Looney Tunes? And if she is, could, you know, you say that so that we can get her off the board. Now, Dr. Price is $300 in debt, and they offer him $600, which, you know, when you figure in for inflation, would probably be about $20,000 today, so you're not going to turn that down. Now, before I go into it any more, Darkrealmers, here's the trailer for you to look at.
It's a gargantuan seven-storied structure with no apparent rhyme or reason. Each maze of halls more confusing than the next.
It's under never-ending construction. It was built on the orders of a grieving widow.
Sarah Winchester is the majority shareholder of the Winchester Repeating Arms Company.
You want to take it away from her?
We're worried about her sanity, Dr. Price.
Do you believe in ghosts, Doctor?
I do not believe in anything I cannot see or study.
Feel it. In the air, in the walls. This spirit has a power we've not seen before. It has found us.
Okay, Darkrealmers. Now, this is one of the great things I found about this movie was the depth of the characterizations. Helen Mirren plays Sarah Winchester wonderfully, and at no stage does she come across as a mad woman or she's, lost her senses or anything like that. Everything she says, even if Dr. Price doesn't believe what she says, comes across as very believable, genuine, all that sort of thing. And he's basically, he doesn't believe in spirits and so forth, and she does. And she's telling him that the only way is to trap them in a room and basically use 13 nails and a piece of wood to lock them in the room until they, decide to move on or, they're at peace. And it's amazing. The cinematography is wonderful in this Darkrealmers because the actual Winchester home is now owned by someone else, and they've turned it into a tourist attraction, and they don't allow photographs or flash photography or anything like that. So the set designers and the stage builders had to do it from just how they imagined it or how they pictured it, just using from the outside, shots from the outside that they could readily see and so forth. And another reason they obviously couldn't film inside was because a lot of the corridors and the stairwells were very narrow, so there was not enough room for the filmmakers to actually film a lot of the shots there. And an interesting historical fact is that Sarah Winchester suffered debilitating arthritis, and she could barely lift a leg, a few inches above the ground. So there were small rises for her to manage going throughout the house. Now, also in this story is Marion, who's Sarah Winchester's niece, and her son Henry, and he's the focus of this energy or this entity because he's constantly waking up, sleepwalking, putting a bag over his head, and walking out at one stage, he almost, walks off the ledge of a building, but he's saved by Dr. Price. Now, Sarah Winchester confiscates his laudanum and says, no, for what we need to do for you to see and understand everything I'm talking about, you need to have a clear mind. So he had to go through a detox. Now, I'm not going to spoil, obviously I don't spoil Darkrealmers, but one of the things that did put me off about the movie was there were a number of jump scares at the beginning of the movie, and they almost came so regularly that you sort of become tired of them before you got really into the movie. And you've got to set that aside and let yourself be immersed into the movie, because there is a single there's multiple ghosts and spirits and so forth, but there's one who is very powerful and who's causing misery and wants Sarah Winchester dead. And this is where they took historical license, Darkrealmers, because they say that this character's brothers were killed by Winchester rifles during the Civil War. Well, this Winchester rifle wasn't around during the Civil War, but it's Hollywood. You've got to give them, a bit of give and take. But this is really, really well acted, okay? And it was nice to see a couple of Aussie actors in there too. We had Bruce Spence, who's a veteran Australian actor, and he plays the butler, who's very stern, he's very dour. And when Dr. Price questions him, have you seen anything strange, he just clams up. And we know that he's seen things, but he doesn't want to talk about them. And another younger Australian actor who's only just started to make a name or getting a bit of recognition in Hollywood is Angus Sampson. And he plays the foreman who's in charge of all these builders who are working, employed by Sarah Winchester, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week to construct these rooms and always, make sure that the building is always evolving, because once one ghost has been contained or moved on, they pull that room down and they build another. It's a really, really good movie, Darkrealmers. The set decoration is just gorgeous. You get a very strong feel for it. The time period, which takes place in 1906, and it does touch on something that did happen to Sarah Winchester, and that was that the horrific San Francisco earthquake, and she gets trapped in a room. Now it's a little bit different to what happened to the actual Sarah Winchester in real life, but of course for the sake of the movie you accept it. And I didn't know that till I read about the movie afterwards, Darkrealmers. But set wise it's brilliant. The creepiness, the sense of foreboding, because the set, it's heavy furniture, that dark furniture that tends to draw the light out, and make it a bit oppressive. That all works very well in favour of the movie. And as I said, Helen Mirren is just wonderful, because she gives a performance that, rather than being this terrified old woman, she's determined that she's going to, put these spirits to rest. She doesn't hate them. She doesn't, fear them. She believes she's got a mission, and that is to, because her... And she says this herself in the movie, when he first gets there, Dr. Price, and he says, "Oh, I believe, your guns are, the best on the market." She says, "What for? Killing?" And so she realises that, that he's just trying to be polite, but that's all her company's, does. It manufactures guns that kill things, and a lot of those things are people. You will really enjoy this movie, Darkrealmers. As I said, the jump scares at the beginning of the movie do tend to detract from the film itself, because I was thinking to myself, oh, don't tell me I'm going through an hour and a half of jump scares. I really, that does tend to put me off. But no, they're very much there to just establish, that these ghosts are everywhere. They're in every room. And Dr. Price first encounters one in his mirror, and it's supposed to be behind him, those sort of things. But there, the scares aren't over the top, but there are a couple of scenes, and there's one where Dr. Price and Sarah are trying to confront this ghost, who is from basically the Civil War era. Well, that is my review for the movie Winchester. I hope you've enjoyed it. If it's made you want to see the movie, let me know in the comments below. And if you have seen it yourself, tell me, what did you think of it? Especially, I'd like to know what you thought of the performances, because I thought they were brilliant. And it was really nice to see, as I said, a co-production between Hollywood and Australia do really well at the box office. So it's a fascinating movie, and also the history of Sarah Winchester is fascinating itself, and you might want to check that out for yourselves after seeing the movie Darkrealmers. Okay, well, that's it for me, horror author and illustrator Michael J. Elliott. And as I always say at the end of my movies, if you're going to be exploring old rooms in creaky old 1906 mansions in San Jose, California, keep the lights on. Bye for now, Darkrealmers.